Hey folks, it's a beautiful day, bright and shiny. I'm trying to get some work done today and I figured I'd bring you people with me because why the hell not? What else have I got to do? So I've got the light flicking in and out, but I'm working with natural sunlight here and a tablet, and it limits the way things work. Now I'm just going to put some music on. I'm just going to rock some Billie Holiday because, oops, why not rock some Billie Holiday? Okay, I got my riser going, I'm working. What I'm working with today are my Inktense water-soluble pigment pencils. Love Derwent, love Inktense. If you like working with watercolors and you want more control, try these. The pigments are bright and beautiful like ink, and I just think they're brilliant. I love the new pieces. Started today on a drawing I started the other day, and I just liked it so much it decided it wants to be a painting, so we're going to make it into a painting. Color schemes can be difficult to choose. I think this one wants to be a warm pitch. Maybe that's because we got Billy going, and you know, Billy's warm. So what was I thinking today? Well, not much really. I was just thinking it was a beautiful day. And it's bright and sunny, but it's too cold to be outside because Canada, right? You can't really enjoy watching the back of my head like this. I'm gonna try moving the camera. Yeah, the light's better there, I think, too. You can't see what I'm doing so much, but we can talk at least. Okay, so regarding the channel, one thing I'm asking people to do at this point is to send me questions. Because one of the things I get to do as compensation for being as fucked up and broken as I am is I don't work full time because I'm simply not capable of it. Major depression means that sometimes when life gets very stressful for me, I get very, very depressed and can't function. Sometimes that can last months. Not the kind of thing your boss wants to hear about, really. Sliding cameras. I will work out something for this. I just don't have a lot of money to spend. Because I do live on disability, so I kind of just got to work with what I got. And anyway, so what I was saying is that one of the benefits of that is that I get to spend a lot of time doing research on things that affect my life as well as things that just generally interest me. I also get to paint, which is like massive, massive bonus. Believe me, I recognize that. I still have ink on my hand from yesterday, don't I? And if I put it there, it's too dark. And if I put it here, it's too... Oh, that good? No, it's still too dark. Ah, fuck it. I'll get the hang of this someday, YouTube. Need a better camera. I'm going to start using my laptop for this. My inherited laptop that I got from somebody. But it needs a new power cable. So until I get that sorted, I can't really work with that. Just Cheers and sliding webcams. Yay! Shit's exciting on the channel today, boys and girls. So what I'll show you. Is a big fucking rip. Inhale. What I will also show you is that I started this drawing the other day. I've gone upside down. I'm gonna have to seriously edit this. Just laid down some color with it. And I'm gonna apply water to that. Not working.
It rolled.
My fucking vape just rolled under the coffee table. I can't do this. None of this works.
Breathe.
It's the light's wrong, and this one, the camera won't stay put. Oh, skip this song for me, will you? Anyway, so back to work. What I was saying is that now I'm taking a brush, just water on it, and I'm fanning out the pigment that I just put down dry. And I get what's called a nice little wash. Just kind of melts all of that pigment because it is water soluble. Ha ha ha, thus the words on the packaging. So what that makes lets me do is it lets me make these nice little clouds as a background. So when you see something that's got like very open cloudy colors as a background, that's what it's called. We call it a wash. Nice work if you can get it, and you can get it if you try. As for anything more. Yeah, I know. So, should we be talking about something weed subject matter? Possibly. But that's part of what I wanted to talk about, is that I was watching a video by another weed tuber. And in it, she was talking about normalizing Stony Sprite, it was. If you don't follow Stony Sprite, give her channel a look. She's a photographer. She does some interesting stuff. And she was talking about not about she wanted the future of her channel to be more normalizing and showing her real use levels as a functioning patient, or even as a functioning recreational user. I'm not sure which category she falls into, but and she was saying that a lot of her channel, not to be surprised if things in her video channel don't show her smoking all the time. And I thought that's a good idea, because this is the thing, is that those of us who are using for medical purposes don't necessarily want to be chasing that high. We're looking for functionality here. So it's a slightly different perspective than what recreational users want. which is actually really funny considering that those of us who are medical users are probably spending more money and using more consistently than any recreational user. So, dispensaries, you know, people in the industry, we're the big money market. So, while we love our recreational use, I mean, as far as I'm concerned, it's a friggin' bonus. You have to keep in mind that we're not all people looking to get as stoned as possible, as much as possible, as quickly as possible. It's just not how it works. I mean, people gotta go to work, people gotta do shit. So, I've laid down this kind of golden color here as my background, and this paper, you know, this paper says it was multimedia, and I decided to take a chance on using this sketch paper instead of getting a piece of watercolor paper out that's made to take water, and it's doing the wrinkly thing already, so, but we will persist, because maybe I can iron it out, and at the very least, I can scan it. So yeah. Oh shit. Do you have your sharpener around handy somewhere?
Hang on. It's old leather.
Okay, it's just mine is on my desk somewhere. So, thank you. Sharpen a pencil. Aren't you proud? So, just thinking that, you know, that's something to definitely think about, is that, you know, sitting around and smoking up for fun is fantastic, and I'm the last person in the world to criticize that. But we also need to keep in mind that some of us need to function on a daily basis, and we don't have time to build up huge tolerance levels necessary to function while consuming huge amounts of THC. So what we need is more dispensaries providing CBD strains that are going to relieve pain, anxiety, and a number of other issues. I mean, I don't even know what all of the issues are, while keeping things clear-headed, keeping the THC at a reasonable level, or it's something that's balanced out by the CBD and isn't going to leave you feeling all stony and stupid. Because, you know, while it's not me, I recognize that some people gotta go to work. You know, people got kids they gotta mind. You can't be all brain fuzzy on this stuff when you're busy trying to adult. I mean, adulting is hard enough as it is, right? So right now, part of this is an organic, viney detail. And I'm just penciling that in with some green right over, right directly over the yellow that I used earlier. And I'm going to show you where we are in a minute. And I'm not putting weed leaves on this, thank you very much. Just because It's not a weedy piece. It's just a piece. This camera angle is really not doing me any favors. It's probably not doing you any favors either, and I'm sorry for that, but I'm working on it, guys. Okay, so I've got a warm background here. And I chose a coolish green. Excuse me. I have sinus problems on top of everything else. So we're just removing some of the pencil marks now. Because sometimes when I go over this with the water, the pigment will lock the pencil marks in. And I'm notoriously bad for forgetting to take my pencil marks out. My teacher in school used to yell at me about it all the time. Get rid of the pencil marks! Doesn't help that I have a habit of working with pencils that are really softer than I should be working with for sketching or outlining or whatever, but whatever works, right? Now I'm going to choose a finer brush and just gently go over that vine that I drew in here to set that. I want to show this to you, but frankly, I don't want to move the tablet again because it gets so bitchy trying to keep it still. But because I love you, I'll do it anyway. So first thing I'm going to do is pick this up. There you go. So that's where we are right now. And as you can see, I just finished painting in this line work here. And you can see the difference, really. It's hard to tell what you're seeing right now. But as you can see, hopefully, it makes a huge difference just by adding a little bit of water. Also do is add a drop of water there, and that'll make the color very thin, and then we lift it out again, and it just leaves a tiny little tint. I don't know if you can see that, but and it just gives a slightly warmer tone. Now what you'll see here is this funny looking silvery gray stuff on here, and it's something called frisket, and basically it's kind of like a rubber cement, but it won't be affected. There's too much water on the brush there. I want this to stay very, very true to where I put it, so I want to use less water. And so the silvery gray stuff is called frisket, and what it basically does is it keeps the paint from going into the paper, like putting a layer of rubber cement on it. And once you put it on, you paint on it, like I painted on it here, and then you can take what looks like a rubber eraser, basically, and it comes right off, and it leaves the paper alone. So, yeah. Frisket. It's a pretty nifty thing, really. Let's wedge my shit back in. So yeah, I mean, I can get pretty buzzed. But if I do, I can't work so much, even as a painter, which I know a lot of people think is not real work. Because the simple reality is, I need to be able to think very clearly, and I need to have very good, close control over what I'm doing with my hands. Which is part of why I need the cannabis in the first place, is because my hands were really, really getting a problem. I mean, very claw, you know, Wicked Witch in the movies kind of thing happening. That's just not on. I mean, not on. There's a nice cloud for you guys. Got my coffee. I'd be surprised if anybody watches this far, to be perfectly honest with you. Bring up good memories. So, yeah, that's one of the things I was thinking today about, is that, you know, we need to be more careful recognizing that, you know, while a lot of the breeders are going for the big THC, that we need to start looking at breeding plants that highlight other aspects of what cannabis can really do. I mean, like, I was doing some research the other day, and apparently one of the terpenes, which the name escapes me right now, you guys can look it up. I mean, most of you guys probably know as much about weed as I do, really, but that's part of the fun too, is that we're learning together, right? So I figure stuff out, I pass it on to you. And but yeah, like, apparently there's a strain called Durban Gold that I have heard tell of, that apparently the heavy terpene in it actually kind of shuts down the appetite portion of the brain. Which, for those of us who suffer from chronic obesity, for whatever PCOS or whatever problem it is, you know, that's like the holy grail, okay? It just shuts down the urge to eat, the same way THC enhances the urge to eat. This is important stuff. I mean, we should be studying this. It's ridiculous that you can't do the research on this particular cannabis plant. It's just, duh. But anyway, I mean, for those of us who are using for medical reasons, deal. Oh man, to not have to worry about the munchies coming on. I mean, some of us have, for those of us who have multiple medical conditions the way I do, and you know, this could be a great counter to have my favorite strains, or particularly my CBD strains that are my painkillers, are going to be for people who have motion limitations. Having something added into that that will not only not cause the munchies, but will actively reduce your appetite, is brilliant, brilliant, brilliant idea. I mean, we can't move as much as we should, so having something limiting that reaction, I mean, guys, get on it. Not to mention all the recreational users. I mean, Ladies, munchies are fun, we know this, but, you know, 6 size to 18 waistline isn't. Although, you know, hey, I haven't seen an 18 since I was 18. Do I really care? No. It's just more of a case of it's medical thing, and I'd rather be healthier than I am. Okay, so now I've used my little gummy eraser thingy, and I've taken off all of the frisket. And I'm gonna have to try reapplying it to the places where the yellow wash background is. And I have to tab in the green that covered over the places where the frisket was, because I want that to match. And I'm trying to decide if I should keep going with you guys today, or just keep working on my own without the camera running and show you what it looks like at the end. But what I could do probably is just kind of fast forward through a lot of this silliness. I don't know. Where are we now? We're at 25 minutes. Yeah, you guys aren't going to want to watch much more of me just sitting here rambling, I know. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop the video and I'm going to do some work, and I will come back when I've done working on what I'm going to do today with it, and I'll let you guys see it then. So here is what it looks like right now. I'll be back in a little bit. Okay, folks, I'm back, and I'm just gonna show you where we are with the piece. Not terribly thrilled with it. I'm gonna have to do it over on another piece of paper because, as you can see here, if you look, the paper is pilling somewhat. This is a sketch pad, a mixed media type sketch pad that someone gave me, and I want to use it because, well, because I don't have much to spend on things. But I decided to try it out because it did say mixed media, and as you can see, it's not taking the water well. It's gone all wibbly, and there are a few places here where the paper has pilled pretty badly. Aside from having caught the frisket a little bit, at least, which is not really supposed to happen. So, whoops, sorry about that, guys. So, yeah, I'm gonna have to start this piece over. Piece of watercolor paper like I should have done in the first place, but you get an idea of my working process now. And this video has gone on very long, so I'm just gonna wind this up here. You guys have a great day. Insert catchphrase here.